99-year-old Franco Arcebal is one of the last of his era of Filipino veterans who served in World War II. Arcebal spent U.S. Veterans Day in historic Filipinotown at the Valor Memorial, where he joined community members in paying tribute to his fallen comrades.
I am now 100 years old.
Yeah, how does it feel to be the last one?
I was only 21 years old during the war.
We're blessed. We're blessed.
We veterans are now called rare species.
While decades have passed since World War II, Arcebal still vividly remembers his experience.
I was a guerrilla when I was still a teenager. I was captured by the Japanese, sentenced to death by decapitation. I escaped my prison cell and joined the guerrilla warfare until the war was over. I was not a professional soldier, but I started as in a guerrilla missionary activity when I was a new high school graduate.
First-hand accounts like Arcebal's are becoming more rare with each passing veteran, but their descendants continue to remember their place in history. Joanne Pangilinan was present in the Veterans Day celebration to remember her grandfather, who survived the brutal Bataan Death March in 1942.
I'm here to represent my entire family and recognize his service to this country. His name was Sergeant Jacob De Leon Vergas. He served in the United States Armed Forces of the Far East from 1941 to 1946, and he continued to serve the Commonwealth of the Philippine Army until his honorable discharge on 1949. He survived the Bataan Death March and was a prisoner of war at Camp O'Donnell in Tarlac. But before all this, he was just my grandpa.
Another relative of a veteran is Terry Gubatan, who called for greater remembrance of U.S. and Filipino troops' sacrifice.
The takeaway for us in remembering today and this monument is more for us to look ahead, to remember all the things that have happened in the past.
It has been 80 years since World War II, but the fight for recognition and benefits go on for the last remaining veterans like Mr. Arcebal and the descendants of those who fought in the war. Last month, the Filipino Veterans Fairness Act was introduced in U.S. Congress. The measure would offer a need-based pension to the remaining survivors. The bill also directs the Department of Veterans Affairs to consider alternative military documentation when determining benefits eligibility. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.